Hey everybody, my name is Mary Knack and I'm the CEO of EQUESTRIAN'S, and today I'm back with another YouTube video. I think that it's really unsafe to ride without a phone. Anything can happen when you're riding, and you don't want to not be able to call someone because you couldn't find a place to put your cell phone. Entrepreneur Brooke Beers noticed that this was an issue and she solved it. I'm riding, and I'm pretty sure it's a really common issue that a lot of people have to deal with. So pretty much everyone these days has a cell phone. Normally it's a smartphone. Mine is an Apple iPhone. I think that cell phones give us a really big connection to the world these days, whether it's connection to friends and family or connection to people all the way across the world. And I'm not even talking about like apps specifically, but also just being able to call someone. If there's an emergency, you have people you can call, whether it's 911 or someone like a family member or someone who can help you. So one of the challenges I face is that when I'm ready to ride, I never know where to put my phone while I'm riding. Even if I'm just riding in the round pen in an arena, or even if I'm going on a trail ride. So here's my issue. I don't like riding without my phone. And the reason for this is because when you're riding horses, there's always the risk that something is going to go wrong. This is something that all equestrians know and they accept. Even if you have a really, really well-trained horse, things happen because they are horses and they do have minds of their own. Say you were riding down the trail and you fell off of your horse. If you somehow injured yourself, like hurt your leg or your ankle or something where you couldn't walk and your horse ran away, there would be no way for you to get up and go find help if you were miles away from the barn. Now I know this sounds pretty extreme, but it can happen. So having a cell phone with you is extremely important so that you're able to call for help if something does go wrong. So having your phone on you kind of solves the problem of in case something were to go wrong, you would have someone to call, someone to be able to come and help you. But the second problem is, where do you put your phone while you're riding? Whether you ride Western or English, there's really not a lot of options for where you can put your phone. You could always set it on the fence or on a gate or something, but then you really don't have a guarantee that you'll have it when you need it in case something were to happen. And as far as pockets go, for Western riders, you normally wear jeans. So you could put it in your back pocket, which I have done, but this has always been a problem for me, especially when I'm trotting or loping along. My phone will eventually get pushed up like closer and closer to the top of my pocket and eventually fall out. And I find it in the sand later. Oftentimes I listen to music when I ride, so I'll always know when my phone falls out of my pocket because all of a sudden I can't hear my music anymore. This is a big bummer for me because one, I lost my phone, it's now in the dirt, and two, I don't have my music anymore. You can also try putting your phone in your front pocket of your jeans, but as a lot of women know, they really don't make the front pockets on women's jeans large enough for your average cell phone. I think that my cell phone is pretty average size. It's just an iPhone 6S, it's not the Plus, but there are iPhone Pluses, and I know that a lot of Androids are really large as well. It's really hard to fit these phones in your pocket. So honestly, if I tried to, I don't even know that I could fit this in my front pocket. It like sticks up a ton. Oof, I don't know if you can see it, but it sticks up that much. So how am I supposed to ride when it's sticking out of my pocket, and as soon as I start moving, it's gonna fall out? There really isn't any other option when you're riding Western. I mean, you could try putting your phone somewhere on the saddle, but I've done that and it's fallen off. There's really no secure place to put it. Same thing goes if you're an English rider. Some brands of breeches do have pockets, but normally they're not very large, which I've also experienced problems with. So even if your breeches do come with pockets, normally they're not big enough to hold a cell phone. And again, you run the risk of them falling out because there's nothing securing it in there. It's just kind of sitting there waiting for movement to cause it to fly out of your pocket. So as you can see, this is an issue. And I think it's a really common issue because everyone has cell phones. Entrepreneur Brooke Beers noticed that this was an issue and she solved it. Today I introduced to you the horse holster. I think that these wonderful tools will solve this common riding issue. I ride multiple times a week, normally all year round, and especially in the summer, I'm probably riding 6 out of 7 days of the week. Last summer, I had a really big issue with finding places to put my phone while I was riding. As some of you may know, my horse Flynn wasn't 100% trained when I got him, so he would have been considered green last spring, and so that especially made me want to have my phone on me because higher chance of things going wrong on horses who don't have a lot of experience. In late August or early September, I found this awesome company, The Horse Holster, and they make these amazing, wonderful tools that enable you to carry your phone with you while you are riding. I was so happy when I found these because I finally found a solution to be able to keep myself and my horse safe while we're riding. So I just wanted to share this with you guys. I'm super excited about this company, and I actually just became one of their brand ambassadors. So I wanted to take an opportunity to show you guys exactly how the horse holster works and what colors and sizes that it comes in. So the first horse holster design that I got was the slim design, and I got it in the teal color. I got this probably mid-September, and as soon as I got it, I used it right away, and I've pretty much used it every time I've ridden since then. Some of you may know from seeing Equine Essentials on my website and all my tack and stuff, you may know that turquoise is one of my favorite colors in addition to lime green. There's just something about this color that I absolutely love. It is so bright, it is so vibrant, and it's just really appealing to the eye. So I was really excited to find this true teal turquoise color, and it actually matches my turquoise Equine Essentials tack perfectly. So you're probably wondering what on earth this does. Well, I will show you. Okay, so basically, this is the horse holster, and this is the leg strap, and then it also has this no-slip strap right here. So I'm gonna show you the base of the horse holster first. This has Velcro on it, so it will stay secure when you close it. But inside here, there is a pocket to put your phone, and there's also this little zip-up pocket where you could put anything like ID or money or cash or anything that you might need, any sort of identification. So this pocket actually zips, so it's very secure. And then this bigger pocket here, you can easily just slide your phone into like that, and then close the Velcro on it, and boom, it is so secure. This Velcro is extremely strong, so it's not just gonna like fly open. I mean, you can hold it like this, you can try and get it open just by that, and you can't. Your phone will be really secure in here, you don't have to worry about it falling out. So like I said before, this is a slim design, and it fits my iPhone 6s perfectly, and yet it's still slim enough to not be too heavy or anything. I mean, it's super lightweight, I never even feel it when I have it on. Alright, so I'm going to show you guys how exactly the horse holster works. Basically, you just place the holster on your thigh, wrap it around your thigh, pull it through here, snug it up, and then it actually just Velcros onto itself, which you can see back here. Now, this is the no-slip strap, so you can attach it anywhere on your jeans to be able to hook it on, and that way if you're standing, like see here, I can move around, I can run around, and it's not gonna fall off. So this is super handy for barn chores or anything that you're going to do when you're not riding. That way you can just have it on the whole day and it'll work out great. So like I said, this is the slim design, and these are actually on sale right now because they are discontinuing all the colors except for the black and the slim design. However, they do have all the colors in the extra large design, which is honestly just as great. So I'm going to show you guys the XL design and also all the different colors that it comes in. So this is the XL design, and as you can see, it's actually the same exact size this way as the slim design. So at first I was confused, like, wait, they're the same size, but it's actually the width of the design that makes them different. Here you see the super slim design, and then this one is a little bit thicker. So this holster would be absolutely perfect for any otter boxes, any huge phones, like any of the iPhone Pluses or any of like the huge Samsung Galaxies or whatever other Androids there are out there. This would be absolutely perfect for that. It will literally fit any phone size. On the inside, you can see it's basically the same. Like I said, there's a little bit more room in here just because there's like the bigger width. So as you can see, it's very spacious. So any super large phones, any otter boxes, and mine still fits in there, no problem. It's got a little extra room, so if I wanted to add another phone, if like I had a friend riding with me and they wanted to put their phone in there, I could honestly probably fit that in there too. There's still the zip pocket on here, so if you wanted to fit like keys or any identification cards or any money or anything, it will fit in there. Or I mean, keys would even fit in the main pocket too, wherever you want to put it. It's just super spacious and such, I mean, it's so small and convenient and lightweight, but yet it's extremely strong and it will hold a lot of stuff. Some of my favorite things about this is that not only does it come in a great color, it's also so incredibly light. I mean, like I said, I never feel it when I'm wearing it. Whether I'm riding or whether I'm walking around, it just becomes like part of me. Another awesome thing about it is that it is water resistant. So if it were to rain while you were riding, no big deal. All of your stuff will be protected. The horse holster also fits on your belt loops, which is super convenient as well. If you don't want to put it on your leg, you can put it on your belt loop, no problem. The no slip strap right here also comes on and off, so there's just a little clippy on there. You just clip it onto the back of the leg strap like this, put it on there, snap it on, and now it's on and it's safe and it's very strong. So the horse holster comes in 5 main awesome color options. The first one, like you saw, is this wonderful teal, which will match all Equine Essentials turquoise tack. It is like the perfect color. It's a true teal color. So it's not like something where it's like a light, more of a light blue, because they do have this blue color right here, which is, if you want more of a blue, you can use this one. If you want more of a teal, you can use this one. Here's the difference between the two. You can see how it's a little bit different, but they're both really, really vibrant, awesome, super cute colors. So this is the teal and this is the blue. And then of course, like you saw, they have the purple color, which is also awesome. It's very bright and it's a very nice, pretty shade of purple. It's nothing too overpowering. It reminds me of like lilac color, that sort of thing. It's a really nice shade, yet it's simple and very classy. The next color they have is this wonderful hot pink. This is very bright and very cute. If you really want to make a statement, this one is for you for sure. And then the last color is of course black, because that matches anything and it goes with any outfit, any tack. Anytime you just want to be like simple, classy, you know, whatever, you can always use the black. It's a very nice color to match anything. As you all know from my previous videos and probably from following me on social media, I love to match everything. Matching is like one of my favorite things to do. Even if I'm just going on a trail ride, I have like my reins and Flynn's boots and his saddle pad, and I have his wither strap, and everything is coordinated, and it's really exciting for me because now I can coordinate something else as well. So now that I've kind of shown you guys what the horse holster is about, I'm gonna take you to the barn with me, do a little vlogging so you can see the horse holster in action. So let's go! Alright, so just a little disclaimer, my video quality is probably going to decrease significantly because all of the lenses on my camera happen to have very large focal length, so if I try to hold my camera at the same time as trying to get all my face in, it would not work. So for now, I'll be using my phone, and then hopefully once I'm at the barn, I'll be able to switch back to my camera, assuming I have enough space. I'm only gonna do you wrong. Here's my horse Flynn. He's an 11-year-old gray Arabian gelding. I got him about a year ago now, and today I'm going to be having him help me showcase the horse holster. Let it go, at the roadside.
Brian's here, and I've got him tied. We just got done with his ride, and he was really good. Neighbor cat.
Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and if you have any suggestions or anything, feel free to comment. Thanks, guys.